Come again to our online service. Being 25 July 2020, we share the word of God together and you will be blessed. The last Sunday, we spoke about ministry and camp. And also today, we are going to study about ministry and camp part 2. But today, last Sunday we said, for a ministry to be complete, there are many parts that explain ministry, how to carry ministry in full. Last Sunday we spoke part 1, kingdom view. But today we want us to speak part 2, the role of the Holy Spirit in ministry. Because you can't carry a ministry without the help of the Holy Spirit. The last Sunday we saw how Jesus carried this ministry akiwa anasaidiwa na Roho Mtakatifu. So today we want us now to look the importance of the Holy Spirit in ministry. As far as you're carrying ministry and cut, as far as you're carrying ministry complete, there are some things you need, which is help. Now, the help that you require to carry ministry complete, it is the help of the Holy Spirit. So now, today, we want to focus the roles of the Holy Spirit in ministry. The roles of the Holy Spirit in our ministry. On the roles of Holy Spirit in the life of a Christian, for him to carry ministry complete. Holy Spirit is the Spirit of God. Roho Mtakatifu ni Roho wa Mungu. Holy Spirit is the power of God. When you read in the book of Genesis, the Bible says, when God was creating earth, he was saying, let there be. And in the time that God spoke, it was created. It is not God who created, but he declared, and things was created. What was creating when God speaks? It is the Holy Spirit. When God speaks, he spoke the Spirit. And that Spirit has created now. And in the time that God spoke, it was created. So, the role of Holy Spirit in our ministry, it helps us to create things in our ministry. It helps us to create tangible things in our ministry. Because in the book of Genesis, the Bible says, during the time of creation, in the time that God spoke, it was created. It happened. He said, let there be trees, trees was formed. Let there be soil. Let there be birds of air. And anything that God spoke, it was created. So even as for us to carry ministry effectively, we need to call the help of the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit gives life. Holy Spirit gives life. Many Christians today, they are carrying ministry that has no effectiveness. Ministry that has no fruitfulness. Because they don't embrace Holy Spirit. They carry ministry minus Holy Spirit. Because Holy Spirit is the one who gives life. The Bible says still in the book of Genesis, when God created the man, he breathed to his nostrils, and the man regained life. Meaning, when God breathed, wakati alipulizia mwanadamu hewa yake, mwanadamu akapata uhai. Hii ni kumaanisha pumzi ya Mungu ama roho ya Mungu huleta uhai. In the book of Ezekiel chapter 23, Ezekiel akaulizwa mifupa mikavu inaweza kuishi. He said, it is only you, God, who can know. But the Bible still continues to tell us, wakati Roho Mtakatifu alikuja, the Holy Spirit believes from all the corners. The crying bones regains life. So it tells us, Holy Spirit is the one that gives life. Roho Mtakatifu upeana uhai. Hata kwa huduma, if you want to carry a lively ministry, impactive ministry, we need to call the help of the Holy Spirit. Spirit is life. It means without the Holy Spirit, death takes control. Mali ambapo hakuna Roho Mtakatifu, Roho wa kifo huchukua nafasi. Because Roho Mtakatifu yeye ndiye upeana moyo. Holy Spirit in our ministry, it gives reality. It gives reality. Things that you speak out of the Holy Spirit, it becomes reality. Wakati tulikuwa tunaangalia realm ya prayer aranza, we discovered there is a realm we call heavenly realm. There's that realm where things of this universe, the things that you see physical manifesting themselves in our life, they first begin in the atmosphere, in the spiritual realm, in the heavenly realm. So the ones that you speak in the spirit, the first man, we speak them in the spirit, they are being formed in the spirit, then they become reality in the spiritual life. So Holy Spirit, it brings things that we want reality. It brings what we want reality. It brings reality things in our ministry. Holy Spirit brings acceleration of spirit. That is the reason why when Jesus was departing the book of John chapter 14, verse 16 and 17, Yesu akasema, mimi nitamuomba Baba, naye atawapa msaidizi mwingine, ili akae nani hata milele. Kwa mstari wa 16 unasema, Jesus told his disciples, yeye after departing, he will request his Father to send helper to them, who is the Holy Spirit, na atakaye kaa na wao milele. Ili kumaanisha, you cannot carry a ministry you alone. You need to carry a ministry by the help of the Holy Spirit. Na Biblia inasema Yesu alisema wakati ataomba Mungu atume Roho Mtakatifu, atakuja akae na nyinyi alafu aende, atakuja na akae na nyinyi milele. So for a man to carry ministry complete, he must first seek the help of God. And when the Holy Spirit will descend, he will stay and help him to carry ministry complete all the days of his life. Verse 17 says, ndiye Roho wa kweli ambaye ulimwengu hawezi kumpokea kwa kuwa haumuoni wala haumtambui, bali ninyi mtamtambua, maana anakaa kwenu naye atakuwa ndani yenu. Yesu akaambia wanafunzi wake, huyo Roho akikuja, watu wa ulimwengu wanaweza kumkataa, wanaweza kumkubali, maana hawatamuona. Lakini akawaambia, lakini nyinyi mtamuona na mtamtambua, maana atakuwa anakaa pia ndani yenu. Hii ni kumaanisha Holy Spirit is not visible with visible eyes. Holy Spirit is a spirit. Ni roho tu. Na Biblia inasema in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 13, neno la Mungu ni ujinga, inakaa kama ujinga kwa wanaopotea. People don't know God, they believe, they see things, they see only the things like foolishness. Wanakaa mambo ya Mungu ni upuzi. Neno la msalaba ni ujinga kwa waliopotea. Na ndio maana Yesu alikuwa anaambia wanafunzi wake, huyu Roho Mtakatifu wakati atakuja, watu wengi watamkataa. Ulimwengu wazi mkubali, maana watakuwa wanamuona. That is the reason why now the current Christians, many non-believers, they don't believe in Christians. Kwa sababu ile maisha wanakaa, the reality kwa ground, vitu ni different. Yale maisha watu wa Kristo wanakaa, you can't be mine if you are an unbeliever. Because they carry ministry without Holy Spirit. Hawezi mtambua Roho Mtakatifu, wampe jukumu wa walinde, ama watangulia kufanya, kubeba huduma, kufanya hii ministry ndio maana unaona maisha wa Kristo wengi wanakaa maisha uwezi hata amini. But Jesus said, when I go to my heavenly Father God, I will request him to send help back with the Holy Spirit. Na Roho Mtakatifu akikuja atamsaidia. Ata aliwaambia wanafunzi wake, Roho Mtakatifu akikuja atamsaidia na atakaa na nyinyi kila wakati. Mstari wa 17 unasema, na huyo Roho Mtakatifu ni Roho wa kweli. Na duni na wakati atakuja watu wa ulimwengu wengine watamkataa, maana hawatamuona na maana hawatamtambua. Lakini nyinyi wanafunzi wangu mtamtambua na mtamjua, maana pia atakuwa anakaa ndani yenu. Nini kumaanisha? We need him now, Holy Spirit, even to stay within us. Unahitaji Roho Mtakatifu akae ndani yetu ili atusaidie kutekeleza huduma kamilifu. Holy Spirit is the power of God. Holy Spirit brings reality in the spiritual realm. It brings reality in the physical life. Whatever we speak, being helped by the Holy Spirit, inaweza kuchukua miaka 10, 3 years, 2 years, but one day it will come to manifest. Because the physical life that we stay, the first beginning in that atmosphere, in the realm, in the spiritual realm, whatever you see manifesting in the life of a man, it first begins in the spiritual realm. So when the Holy Spirit came, he helped us. Whatever we speak in the spiritual realm, they become reality in our physical life. He strengthened the activity of our spiritual senses. He strengthened our activity. He strengthened our spiritual senses. Kuwa na Roho Mtakatifu utajua ni wapi unapaswa kuenda kuhubiri, ni wapi unapaswa kuenda, ni wapi unapaswa kufanya, ni wapi unapaswa kufanya. Because your spiritual senses are very strong. That is the work of the Holy Spirit in a Christian or unbeliever. To strengthen his spiritual muscles. He strengthens your spiritual muscles. He raises your spiritual antenna. Unakuwa na network za kiungo kila wakati. Si kutupa network. Many Christians, they lose network in our ministry because they don't have Holy Spirit. But when you embrace Holy Spirit, when Holy Spirit is sent to you, atakusaidia, he will give you network to carry ministry completely. So now, the work of the Holy Spirit there is to strengthen our spiritual muscles, to strengthen our spiritual antennas. He will help us to understand what to do in ministry and what not to do. That is the reason why wherever Jesus went, despite persecution, despite rejection, Jesus knew very well what to do. Akiulizwa maswali anajibu. They wonder, what a man, what a wisdom this man bestowed. That is because he had Holy Spirit. So even us, in our ministry, we need Holy Spirit to help us. We need Holy Spirit to help us. And remember, Holy Spirit, he acts as an intermediary. He introduces us into the spiritual realms. Holy Spirit is the one who carries a man, introduces a man in the spiritual life, in the spiritual world, where things are not ordinary, where there is no distance of time, introduces a man in the spirit, in the spiritual world. Roho Mtakatifu ni yeye ukamata mtu na kumpeleka katika ulimwengu wa roho. He introduces him there. And for you to carry a message, you need to understand what is happening in the second realm. Leave about the physical life. You need to understand what is happening. The business taking on How will you access now? Utaidaje in the spiritual world. It is by the help of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is the pioneer, is the introducer of Christians. Ni haya atakuchukua. Akupeleke katika ulimwengu wa roho. Introduces you there. For you to understand the ministry, the mystery in the atmosphere, in the spiritual realm, the spiritual richness, you need now to be introduced in the spiritual realm. And for you to be introduced, you need the Holy Spirit, because He's the one who will introduce you there. Holy Spirit brings result of our grievances or our prayer. Why am I saying this? Because the Holy Spirit is the custodian of God's power. Holy Spirit is the custodian of God's power. So the declaration requests God anatutumia. It is the Holy Spirit who answers us. Because it is our help. And you might be willing to say, since katika kitabu ya Wakorintho, sisi hatujui kuomba, but it is the Holy Spirit who intercedes on our behalf. We don't know how to pray, but it is the Holy Spirit who intercedes on our behalf. So for a man to carry ministry complete, he needs to ask help of the Holy Spirit. He needs also for a man to carry ministry complete. Lazima awe na usaidizi wa Roho Mtakatifu. So that now the Holy Spirit can bring the result. Wakati? The reason why Christians are not believing their preachers or their pastors, it is because pastor preach, pastor pray for them, nothing is happening in the physical life. Then they start doubting the man of God. The problem is not the man of God. The problem is that the man of God is not introduced to the Holy Spirit. So whatever he's doing is doing out of his own knowledge and out of his own wisdom. Maana Biblia imesema tutakapokuwa na Roho Mtakatifu atatusaidia kwa maisha yote milele to carry the ministry. And we have seen the Holy Spirit brings the result, because he is custodian of God's power. So for us to carry ministry, we need now to have Holy Spirit. We need to have Holy Spirit. We need to have Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit brings transformation.
Receive all the praise and all the honor.
pass Jesus to carry ministry complete. Roho Mtakatifu tusaidie. Pass Roho Mtakatifu to carry ministry complete. Because we have seen you are the one who gives life. We pray for the your spirit to give life. We pray. May your spirit give us life in our ministry. Because we pray for our ministry to start being effective because of your presence, Holy Spirit. By the power of God, help us to carry ministry complete. I pray for my viewers, bless them, preserve them, Holy Spirit, incubate their life with your fire, Holy Spirit. We give you praise and we give you glory. And it is in that shortly we pray. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Stay blessed.